I think at that level, I think you just have to get a break. Somebody's got to say, hey, I'm going to take a chance on this guy. And I don't think Britt really got that one chance where he could actually go show it. He just impressed me immediately. We had just started a basketball team about 2 years ago at the school, and I told him, I said, you're going to play with me next year, and he was only going to be in fifth grade. Then each year he just got better and better.
Gary Adams, being that he is a Caucasian guy, it was huge for me because growing up in the inner city of Chicago and where I grew up at, it was no white people.
He was my same gym teacher and showed me how to shoot a free throw. He's an inspiration because he has the ability to motivate and influence Britt.
And to meet him and to see the way that he embraced me and the way that he pushed me to be the best that I can be, it was like one of the greatest feelings in the world. This is where it all started for me at when it comes to basketball. Coming up to this court, it's like being at home. Like Cooper Park to me, great athletes. We had Brian Durr, Quentin Richardson, Rico Hill, Theo Hutchinson, and I mean a ton of other guys, man. This is home. This court means everything to me. And I mean, there's days when you can come out here and we get the plan. And I mean, it's packed. This park gets surrounded with spectators and fans and people that enjoy to watch us play at a very high level for free. This is all we have in our neighborhood. I mean, we don't got a swimming pool at the park. We very rarely play baseball or football. We play basketball. So I mean, it was 24/7, 7 days a week. Right here at Cooper Park.
I got a story that maybe Britt don't even remember. It's this cat, he was killing on the tournament side. You know, his name was ringing through the city. We had our tournament, man, at Cooper Park. Britt came in, got his hair cut for the game, and we was talking. Britt told me, I'm about to murder this dude. He told me, I'm about to murder this dude, man. And I got off work, I went to the park. What'd you drop that game?
Man, I had like 30 in the first half.
Yeah, yeah, you know what I'm saying? It was real.
Out of all the kids I've had, and coached Dwayne Wade, Quentin Richardson, talent-wise, yeah, he could do what they could do. As far as handling the ball and shooting the ball, playing defense, which nobody played defense like that. Nobody I've ever seen.
Childhood friend and lifelong teammate. We've been playing together since we were 10 years old.
Oh yeah, one of the best players ever in Chicago right there. That's Rico Hill.
I mean, he always used to joke about doing a Donald Whiteside. Well, Donald Whiteside was an NBA rookie at like 32 years old. So I just feel like when you believe, anything is possible. And you know, God has a way of, how you say, letting you do what you want to do until it's time for you to do what you meant to do.
Basketball is a vehicle. It's a vehicle for you to get to a destination. And Britt has a chance to get to his destination that he decided to do maybe a long time ago. But as of right now, he has that opportunity meeting him in the face. So to stay in shape, to stay mentally focused, ready to play, this is a phenomenal example of hope.
It's about wanting it. You know, you can coach a lot of things, but the things that you can't coach that are the most important are character, heart, and desire. Things that don't show up on the stat sheet, they're called intangibles. And those Britt are rich with.
I love to see people who love the game. It's a jump ball.
He's very passionate about what he does. I always respected him as a person and a ball player. So I wish him nothing but the best.
It's amazing that you go all those years and he stayed in shape. He kept on playing. He loves the game. And he just never got that one chance.
Right now we're in Inglewood, Chicago. 68 from May, growing up out here as a youngster. This neighborhood means a lot to me because this keeps us grounded. This shows us where we come from, where we at, and more importantly, why we trying to continue to strive and succeed and become a success and go further. So it means a lot because this is Chicago. You know, this is the toughest city in Chicago. And we kept a rim right in the middle of the street. It usually be out there, where we'll go up to the park, up to Ogden Park, right on 69th, and get it in, man.
We live in an age where, you know, at 35, you consider old, especially as far as the game is concerned. You know, so, you know, being a pillar of the community, you know, a man that gives back to the community.
So it's a left to right crossover, jump stop layup, stutter step at the chair, pull up jump shot. Let's go. Let's go. Work, 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 work.
It's not a whole lot of hope, not a whole lot of activities and things going on that they can get into. You know, he's a pillar and he can set an example, and to be able to be 35 and to be given the opportunity to continue to live out his dreams, you know, it kind of lets people know that it ain't over. You know what I'm saying? You can still continue to strive. Don't give up your dreams. Keep moving forward. You know, don't let the media, don't let the system tell you that you can't do it. And for him to be granted this opportunity, you know, he's a living example.
He's the only person I know who actually is so committed to achieving his dream that I've ever seen in my life.
What I liked about him is he never complained about it. You know, I don't get this and I didn't get this and nobody's looking at me. He just kept on going after it. You know, he would just go out and play. I admire him more than anybody else because he's been turned down and turned down and shuffled to the back. He finally got that shot, and I'm just thrilled for him.
So whomever has that opportunity to have him on the team has definitely invested in a jewel.
At 35 years old, this is real serious to me. This is no game, and you know, I'm very passionate about it, and I'm ready to attack it full force.
Once he's got his foot in the door, he ain't gonna be in there stopping him.
Hey, may the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. We ain't even thinking that far. You know what I mean?